actresses like Olivia de Havilland, who I've covered previously, Loretta Young wanted to transition to TV when it started booming in Hollywood at the end of the 40s. A new decade started, which meant a new film formula was created. Just as it did from the 20s transitioning to the 30s, with sound films, new actresses were introduced. It was not her time yet to transition, and she decided to continue her success in film rather than TV. Loretta Young's rise to become an Oscar winner was strategic and committed, and she did not fall into acting by mistake, but worked on projects she deemed worth her time since the 1920s. But that doesn't mean that she didn't experience a series of stumbles in her life. Her tireless and intricate work ethic indicated her passion towards acting, and her meaningful Oscar win for a controversial film makes her a film icon. Loretta, formerly Gretchen, began appearing as an extra since she was 4 years old, because her two older sisters were small actresses and her brother-in-law an assistant director. She began to take acting seriously early on and scored minor yet effective roles in The Only Way and The Primrose Ring. By her teens, she knew that acting was for her. She changed her name to Loretta and started learning everything about film production, from lighting to camera angles to learning her lines incessantly. Her small yet strong frame, big green eyes and fair complexion made her the perfect ingenue for the films. She started numerous films through her teens and was second billing in The Headman in 1928. By her 20s, Young was part of the Fox team after leaving First National Studios, thus making her a major Hollywood staple. She got to transition from ingenue to leading lady at this time. An unfortunate incident happened in 1935, which startled Young's career and public image. Her co-star in 1935's Call of the Wind, the infamous Clark Gable, who was married at that time, assaulted Young when she was 22, and she consequently got pregnant. She hid from the media and public to not taint her wholesome and strictly Catholic image. Filming of movies that Loretta had lined up were cancelled, and Loretta and her mother went AWOL. Since she had her baby daughter, she kept the whole situation a mystery and pretended that she adopted her daughter. Loretta's daughter found out later in life that her father was in fact Gable. Loretta Young later married her second time to Tom Lewis and had two sons with him, and gave Judith, now Judy, the last name Lewis. Despite this drama, Young was a sought-after actress and went on to work on more projects, even when she was pregnant with her children. She went on to star in Kentucky in 1938, which was a huge success. In 1939, she decided to reject the 5-year, $2 million contract with 20th Century Fox and worked freelance instead. Young wanted important and powerful roles and disagreed with Hollywood execs too much. She wanted respect, recognition, and an Oscar. During World War II, she starred in Lady Courageous, and in 1947, she starred in a massively popular film, The Farmer's Daughter. It challenged the status quo in American society because although it was considered a bright comedy, it discussed topics of immigration and politics in the US. And for the major character that Loretta played in Farmer's Daughter, she won her first nomination for the Best Actress Oscar in 1948. Shocked yet jubilant, Young flowed to the stage in an emerald green taffeta dress to accept her statuette. At the end of her speech, she said to her golden statue,
"And as for you, at long last."
That same year, an equally successful film Young starred in came out, named The Bishop's Wife. However, as the 40s came to an end, her filmography tapered, although her films were still successful, including Mother is a Freshman, Come to the Stable, and It Happens Every Thursday. But that did not mean that Loretta would be done with show business. She eventually transitioned to TV. thousands, and eventually millions by 1953, households had television sets. Now, Loretta's fans could watch her on the regular in the comfort of their own home. She actually ran her own NBC show starting in 1953 called The Loretta Young Show. All the way up until 1961, Loretta hosted a half-hour drama anthology series in which she regularly acted in two. Everybody loved her dazzling entrances and beautiful gowns. And for this show, Loretta won multiple Emmys for Best Actress in a Dramatic Series in 1954, 56, and 58. After the show ended, Loretta went on to launch other shows, but they were unsuccessful. In 1986, Young won a Golden Globe for her role in Christmas Eve. Lady in the Corner was her final TV film appearance. Now we know just how hardworking and passionate Loretta Young was about acting. She knew the business inside and out and fascinated audiences for many years. She said, "A charming woman doesn't follow the crowd. She is herself." She always appeared in interviews, photo shoots, and it got talked about a lot in gossip columns at the height of her career. She worked throughout the silent, sound, technicolor, TV, and radio eras of Hollywood, making a list of performances very extensive. And by the time she retired, she had a tight-knit, loving family, grandchildren, and time to sleep in and travel. Loretta Young embarked on a journey of a lifetime to become one of the best actresses, mainly in the 1930s and 40s cinema. And for her hard work, professionalism, and beauty, she did receive an Oscar.